You've heard this before. An important goal for diabetes management is spending as much time in range as possible. As a reminder, time in range equals time spent between 70 and 180 milligrams per deciliter, and the SmartGuard feature can help. Remember, even though the MiniMed 780G system delivers auto corrections that can help if you've underestimated carbs or missed a meal dose, the timing of your bolus is still really important. For example, waiting too long to bolus can cause your sugars to go high at first, so you'll want to avoid this as often as possible. That said, if you feel more comfortable waiting, consider bolusing for some carbs before your meal to help keep you in range, perhaps the ones that you're sure you'll eat. As always, it's a good idea to spend some time discussing this and other bolus strategies with your healthcare provider. Use the SmartGuard Bolus feature on your pump as often as possible. This feature takes some of the guesswork out of delivering insulin before meals and snacks. To use it, from the home screen, simply press the down arrow for the shortcut to the SmartGuard Bolus feature. It's important to note that sensor glucose will automatically display in the bolus screen and will be used to calculate a bolus, unless you've entered a meter blood sugar reading into the pump in the past 12 minutes. All you'll need to do is enter the estimated grams of carbohydrate you're about to eat, and the system will calculate the recommended insulin dose for you based on the settings programmed into the pump by your healthcare provider. If you need to add more carbs later for additional foods eaten, you can. Heads up, make sure to avoid bolusing for carbs that you're not eating. We call these phantom or fake carbs. Doing so may cause you to go low. Speaking of, let's talk about low sugars or hypoglycemia next. It's important to treat a low with 15 grams of fast-acting carbohydrates, or the right amount determined by you and your healthcare provider. If you treat with more than 15 grams and end up having a high sugar down the road, don't worry, you can correct with some insulin as needed. That said, it's a good idea to talk to your healthcare provider about ways to avoid rebound highs. Which reminds me, have you ever had a high sugar that just won't budge or come down, even after a correction bolus? That's typically a sign that something is off. This is where it is important to have a backup plan. Maybe your infusion set pulled out of your skin, or there's an air bubble in your tubing. These situations will require you to activate your backup plan. We recommend that you always carry the items on this list. That way, you can take action to bring your sugar levels down to an acceptable range, and most importantly, stay safe. If you continue to notice your sugar levels changing and varying significantly, make sure to check in with your healthcare team. It's possible your settings need some fine-tuning to help keep your sugar levels in range. Keep it up, and with these tips and your help, I have no doubt you'll be a time-in-range champion in no time.